Good afternoon. My name is Philippe Denis. I am a Chief Anticipation Officer at BNP Paribas Security Services. I've been working in the bank for more than 30 years. And for the last 10 years, I have been in charge of research and development, digital strategy, anticipation, blockchain activities. So how does it look like on a day-to-day basis? This type of job, I guess you can ask yourself. This is a little bit, in fact, the type of topics that we are confronted, because when you arrive with new topics in our organization, there is always something else to do than to focus on the future vision, I will say, of the world. I have developed what I have called the percolation theory. Percolation theory is quite simple. It takes roughly, when you have one innovative idea, it takes 3 years to get sponsorship and budget, and it takes again 3 years to implement on an industrial case. So from end to end, you have roughly 6 years. I've been testing this concept with other companies like L'Oréal, Thomson Reuters, and most of them are still in the same principle. So percolation is a key element. In the digital world, what we know is that we need to accelerate the first 3 years that are mainly the decision timing. This is a little timeline in order to say what we have done on AI. On AI, we have been doing mainly two key elements regarding, I will say, interaction with clients. On the first top line, you will see what we have done on natural language generation. The capability to take some data and then to automate a text at the end of the day to give to a client. As you can see, we have identified this type of technology quite early in 2011, and we did some documents for clients. Then we also did documents for the regulator. One document has never been produced by, I will say, an employee. It was automatically, I will say, managed by a natural language generation for AIFMD. And then a little bit later, we have done fund manager comments in various languages, because when you distribute a fund, you have to write the comment in the language of the country. And in 2017, we have been able to implement, I would say, competence center on this natural language generation, and in 2018 to implement. So you can see that the timeline is quite significant. On the other side, when you look at the bottom, we are more talking about Amelia, where we first met Amelia in 2013, but which was introduced in the Gartner Forum in Barcelona. And then in order to promote Amelia, we have made some video that we are going to explain what was Amelia, how it could interact with us or with our client, in order to give to the people the perception of what it could deliver. And these were videos that were looking like Amelia, but that were not Amelia, in order to have a kind of education of the team, whether it was top management or whether it was our staff. In 2016, the G100 of the bank gathered for one half a day in order to discover digital transformation. At the end of 2016, I will say the CEO of the bank, Jean-Laurent Bobonafé, decided to allocate a budget of $3 billion on digital of transformation for the bank. 2017, then we set up Amelia. So we did the first use case with real Amelia at the end of the year. For 1 month, we did a full use case with connection to the platform, with interaction with, our staff. And since then, now we are implementing Amelia on a specific use case that I will define. By implementing Amelia, sometimes we have got some very specific feedback. One of the feedback was, in fact, why is it a girl? Why is it blonde? And some people are saying, oh, I will prefer a man instead of a girl. So what we did in order to solve these issues was quite simple. I created an avatar of myself, which was in fact the alternative to Amelia. Guess what? Since then, there was the option to have or Amelia or myself. The question has never been asked again. Everybody loved Amelia at the end of this session. So sometimes some little tricks can go over big hurdles in order to make it happen. Yeah, and the concept was, of course, Amelio, and just to be sure that we understand fully what we say. What we are implementing now is a shareholder employee for institutional client, where, in fact, an employee of a big corporate can go and see where are the stock options, if they can raise their stock option, if they can get out of their stock options. So we have, I will say apps on this, on the web, or also, of course, on iPad. And the objective was, in fact, to expand these solutions to be able to have self-care functionalities, of course, but also to be able to be open 24/7. And because when we deal with big corporate, they have employees all over the planet, and these guys have stock options on the other side of the world. And usually our support time was from 8 to 6 Paris time. So it was not covering very well Asia, or it was not very covering very well the US. So this is one of the objectives, to have a worldwide coverage, to reduce the number of calls and queries, in fact, to the call center, to improve the service quality, and to be part of the innovative digital strategy that we are implementing. The teams that do the call center are located both, I would say, in Paris and in Lisboa, in Portugal. And then the idea was to get, in fact, these teams for the call center, for the correspondence, what is happening on the web, and also the Planet Shares, which is the name of the website of the solutions that we deliver to this type of clients. How did we define the scope of Amelia? We did data collection. We have been, a lot of speakers have been talking about the importance to gather the data from the team, from the analysis of this discussion, from the type of volume, type of request, because the type of request will drive what you are going to implement at the end of the day as use case or epic. Then you have the voice of the client. Voice of the client is key for us. Client shareholders committee, so we have been meeting with clients at the top level, at the board, but also we have been doing demonstration and feedback. We have been working with on workshop with some of our clients to define what they expected from us. And the workshop, of course, have enabled us with IT and architecture to be able to shape and frame the solution and to define, in fact, of course, the future process, because as you have seen, the actual process, of course, we want to implement it, but the future process will be quite different at the end of the day. The functionalities, as you can imagine, is to be quite reactive. It's to be able to allow people, in fact, to transact on this with Amelia in order to do the operations that they want to do. If they have an issue, they can escalate, of course. And then it's also to implement the auto-learning capabilities in order for Amelia to integrate as soon as she will ask for a supervisor to handle the questions that she cannot, she will not be already ready to answer. The objective, as stated, the benefit that we are waiting from this implementation is an instant response from 24/7, lower the volume of queries, and decreasing the stock of emails that also tend to increase depending on the period of the year and depending on the type of activities that our clients are looking at. In conclusion, I think that what is important in this digital transformation or in the implementation of this type of solutions is, in fact, to have a vision, is to have talent. You need, I would say, as we have seen, people and resources that have the right talent. Of course, you need some budget, because we cannot do everything without some budget in order to make it happen. And mainly, what you need is consistency. That means you have to believe in what you propose, in what you deliver, in what you are going to present, in fact, to your entity, in order to be sure that when you will have the vision the talent, the budget, and the consistency, then you will be successful. Drive the vision is key. It's disruptive because it has not been done before what we are doing. There is not a package as such that you can go and take and implement based on our different use case, because we are each different with the way we interact with our customer. It's a new culture. Historically, it has been quite easy. We are doing a package, implementing it, rolling it out, and deal done. And it's a dangerous world because, in fact, speed is key. That means you have to be very quick in order to roll out your solution, to identify, to implement, and to roll out your solution. Client experience is, of course, at the center of this new transformation. Transversality is key. Because we see that not only we are working with clients, we are working with our business people, we are working with IT, we are working, in fact, with a lot of actors in the ecosystem, and we fully need to be transversal, especially when you want Amelia to be an omnichannel communication vis-à-vis the rest of the world. And the last objective, but not the least, is to be able to reduce the 6 years percolation theory with a new way of thinking and with a new way of interacting, depending on the success that you will be able to demonstrate at the end of the day. Thank you for your attention.